Well, welcome to worship on this Wednesday evening. Glad that you are here with us tonight. Should be a fun service. And just a reminder that starting in August 2nd, next Sunday, we will be worshiping at the drive-in worship at 9 a.m. Not two services, but one service at 9 a.m. Just a reminder for Sunday mornings. Otherwise, we'll continue to be online as usual. But again, let's ready ourselves for worship.
Jesus Christ, you are the light of the world.
The light no darkness can overcome.
Stay with us now, for it is evening.
And the day is almost over.
Let your light scatter the darkness.
And shine within your people here. Joyous light of heavenly glory, loving glow of God's own face, you who sing creation's story, shine on every land and race. Now as evening falls around us, shall raise our songs to you, God of daybreak, God of shadows, come and light our hearts anew. In the stars that grace the darkness, in the blazing sun of dawn, in the light of peace and wisdom, we can hear your quiet song. Love that fills with wonder, love that warms a weary soul, love that bursts all chains asunder, set us free and make us whole. You who made the heaven's splendor, every dancing star of night, make us shine with a gentle justice, let us each reflect your our way. Loving Spirit of salvation, lead us on to endless day.
Blessed are you, Creator of the universe. From old you have led your people by night and day. May the light of your Christ make our darkness bright, for your word and your presence are the light of our pathways, and you are the light and life of all creation.
Sin and disgrace, keep me sheltered by your grace, for I trust that your promise is true. Oh, set my feet on pathways of peace, and teach me to walk in your ways. Let your truth be my salvation shining bright. I will serve you the length of my days. Remember, God, your mercy and love. Forgive me for times when I fall. For your mercy is great to the humble ones who lowly who answer love's for to you we turn our eyes. We will serve you the length of our days.
God of grace and mercy, you are the refuge of all who seek you. You are the shelter of all who wait in hope for you. Set our feet firmly on your pathway and guide us by the light of your truth, so that we might faithfully follow you all the days of our lives. We ask this through Jesus the Christ.
Amen.
The reading for this evening comes from Exodus, the 3rd chapter. Moses was keeping the flock of his father-in-law Jethro, the priest of Midian. He led his flock beyond the wilderness and came to Horeb, the mountain of God. There the angel of the Lord appeared to him in a flame of fire out of a bush. He looked, and the bush was blazing, yet it was not consumed. Then Moses said, "I must turn aside and look at this great sight and see why the bush is not burned up." When the Lord saw that he had turned aside to see, God called to him out of the bush, "Moses, Moses." And he said, "Here I am." Then he said, "Come no closer. Remove the sandals from your feet, for the place on which you are standing is holy ground." He said further, "I am the God of your father, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob." And Moses hid his face, for he was afraid to look at God. Then the Lord said, "I have observed the misery of my people who are in Egypt. I have heard their cry on account of their taskmasters. Indeed, I know their sufferings, and I have come down to deliver them from the Egyptians, and to bring them up out of the land to a good and broad land, a land flowing with milk and honey, to the country of the Canaanites, the Hittites, the Amorites, the Perizzites, the Hivites, and the Jebusites. The cry of the Israelites has now come to me. I have also seen how the Egyptians oppress them. So come, I will send you to Pharaoh to bring my people, the Israelites, out of Egypt." But Moses said to God, "Who am I that I should go to Pharaoh and bring the Israelites out of Egypt?" God said, "I will be with you, and this shall be a sign for you that it is I who sent you. When you have brought the people of out of Egypt, you shall worship God on this mountain." But Moses said to God, "If I come to the Israelites and say to them, 'The God of your ancestors has sent me to you,' and they ask me, 'What is his name?' what shall I say to them?" God said to Moses, "I am who I am." He said further, "Thus you shall say to the Israelites, 'I am has sent me to you.'" God also said to Moses, "Thus you shall say to the Israelites, 'The Lord, the God of your ancestors, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob has sent me to you. This is my name forever, and this my title for all generations. Go and assemble the elders of Israel and say to them, 'The Lord, the God of your ancestors, the God of Abraham, of Isaac, and of Jacob, has appeared to me, saying, I have given heed to you and to what has been done to you in Egypt. I declare that I will bring you up out of the misery of Egypt to the land of the Canaanites, the Hittites, the Amorites, the Perizzites, the Hivites, and the Jebusites, a land flowing with milk and honey.'" Here ends the reading. Well, before I begin this sermon this evening, it's just a reminder that this will be a little different than normal. I wrote it kind of in a limerick style, and so I hope you enjoy it. But here it goes. It might be titled, "No Excuses." One might wonder, what kind of sermon is this? A tome full of rhyming, not sure it is bliss. But for fun in the summer, not your average fare, comes a story that's older than the gray in my hair. The story that's told of a God still so near, a God of love and tenderness, not one of fear. A God who's aware of the Israelites' plight, stuck in Egypt as slaves under Pharaoh's might. God heard their groans and God heard their cries. God could see the struggle for justice in their eyes. One might ask, what's a creator to do? If I might be so bold, maybe you would too. If the world you've created runs away from your love, lives in shackles and power as if from above, but forgets the purpose of life to be lived from the start and rather tries to live with a cold, cold heart. So God decided to act to invite and cajole a human, a man tending sheep in his fold, to be God's voice and God's presence in turn, to show God's desire and the freedom to yearn. The story is heard and told again tonight, so you may rediscover the power of God's might and love and mercy that appears on display for the world to see that God's not gone away. So let me bring in a friend of the past who's present and will be your future at last. A shepherd out minding his flocks in the making, protecting his sheep from the thieves that might be taking. This ain't no story of a run for the roses. It's rather a story of a man named Moses. Our story this day uses Moses as our bait, as God tries to hook us and not make us wait. But there's more to this story than history and such, because there's a point in this mess that we can't use a crutch. So let me introduce myself. Some call me a bush. No, not 41 or 43, not into names that much. I'm more concerned about my people enslaved and merely just sad about how they've behaved. So in hearing their cries of pain and sadness, I'm about to do a new thing to bring them some gladness. I want them to know that I'm real and not phony, not some idol, doll, or thing made of stony. How can they know that I am here and that I hear? I know I'll invite someone with no fear. Let's see. Who could that be? Just light it up and then we'll see. There! Now we're set to see who might be ready. I'm wondering who might have some street creddy. Aha! There is the one I had hoped for. An opportunity offered. He's coming for more. Excuse me, you who over here right this way, come closer so you see, you can hear what I say.
What's this? A fire? There's no such. Won't even go out. I must see closer. Ouch!
Watch it, you silly nincompoop nilly. A fire's a fire, can be dangerous, you silly.
I've never heard a bush forever on fire, nor one that talked from wire to wire.
Silence! Don't you know to whom you are talking? Remove your shoes. Are those things fit for walking?
Well, sorry about that, but this I am certain. Just worried about who is behind the curtain. For I've never seen a sight so rare all my days as a bush that keeps burning, but giving no haze. My curiosity's piqued, but I've been quite drawn in. I don't know what to make of your calling. I'm just a poor shepherd who's minds his own sheep, but lives really quite simply. Not really too deep, but I wonder, what's all the fire about? That's never consumed, it never goes out. Just what do you want from the man who is humble? I do not want trouble, don't want to stumble.
Well, isn't that nice, Mr. Shepherd Aware? I've heard my people's cry from Egypt down there. They lived under oppression from a terrible lout who has used all this horrible, terrible clout to lay this burden upon their lives from slavery's pain and slavery's lies. So I'm fixin' to deliver them to freedom's best hope to remind them that I'm present, not absent. Nope. But I need to offer this chance to a person that they might see I really care. I'm not cursing.
So what could that possibly have to do with me? If you really want to grandstand, just make them see. What on earth could I possibly do to help clean up this mess for you? What are your plans, O bush burning with fire? Who are you really? Tell me plain, for I tire.
Listen here, O Moses, your head is quite dense. Let me tell you quite plainly to help make some sense. I am God. You can call me. I am who I am. And I really don't like green eggs and ham. But wait, I guess I'm getting carried away. I have so much more that I want to say. I want you to go to the Pharaoh so great and tell him he has made me really irate. My people should not be in slavery and such. Freedom's the name of the game and such.
So what do you think? This God sure seems crazy. If I do what he tells, I'll be pushing up the daisy. If I had my right mind, I'd run from this call. But with my luck, I'd trip on my laces and fall. And end up the butt of some sheepherder's joke about squirrels and sheep and some other folk. So I guess I figure I better think fast if I'm ever going to get out of this task. So Why pick on me, oh, Mr. Bush of God? Why did you choose me? Give me the nod. I really can't talk, nor do I have much to say. I don't know how I can help you today.
Excuses, excuses. Is that the best you can do? Like I'm going to go and run away from you. You are Moses, an Israelite, akin to my people whose freedom that you will win. You can be my voice, my bones, and my rump. Heck, you can even act like a chump, but I'll give you the words that you'll need to say to that nasty old Pharaoh when you arrive that day, to let him know I'm sick and tired of his ilk, who always cries over the spilled milk. Tell the big man that my people must go or be ready to face one terrible show.
But I'm tongue-tied and speak with a horrible stutter. There's no one to blame, except maybe my mutter. I'd love to help you. I am filled with fire. But then you could see I'm a terrible liar.
So I've told you before. Now I'll tell you again. I'll be with you. So will Aaron, your brother and friend. He can speak when you can't and give voice to your words, so the Pharaoh will hear even if you look like nerds.
But I'm sure that you could find another who's more competent and strong if I had my druthers. But I guess if you promise to be with me, fine. I'll go tell the Pharaoh, that nasty old swine, to let your people go free, straight on away. I'll tell him that that is all you have to say. I'll be your voice, give flesh to your appeal. I'll put it to him, gonna make him squeal. But how are your people going to know who sent me? Will they even believe that they can be free? Should I give you a name like Doug, John, or Nick? Or do you think they'd wonder, who's that shtick? Have you thought this all through? Are your plans all done? Have you got it mapped out or on the run? Because while I'm standing here warming my feet by the fire, I'm starting to feel my brain start to tire.
Now hold on there, Mo. While your undies in the bind, relax and breathe deep. Start to unwind. I don't have this plan all mapped out, only offering opportunities of which I can tout. All I'm asking is to give of yourself, to put your wants and your needs on a shelf. Tell them I am who I am has sent you, that they may remember the name of the God who has birthed them and loved them and called them by name, whose desire to be in relationship is at the heart of the game. The game we call life, where the rules are a-turnin', where winning is losing and something we're learning. So get on your way with those fancy new shoeses, so my people will be free and the Pharaoh will loses.
Thank you, sir. I am God Yahweh, I think. But you've caught me and sent me with a hook and a wink. I see your intentions are meant only in love for the people who cried and heard from above. But if I may I ask just one more? Can I be so bold as to ask what for? If your almighty hand can by a word bring life, why could you not simply still all the strife? Why take a chance with a man so lowly, whose stuttering makes him talk so slowly? Why take a chance on a man with issues? You might end up using a full box of tissues. Why not use your power to make things all right? Why use someone who could mess things up, right?
That's funny that you should act quite so bold and dare ask questions about things that are old. What would be the purpose of fingers to snap or to turn on the light with a clap of a clap? I didn't choose to create in order to impress, to gain style points, or even impress. I choose to create and create and create that others might know just how I want to relate. Love God and love neighbors are just two simple laws, yet they are hard to keep because they're stuck in your craws. So to you who are sitting out here tonight in this beautiful weather where things are all right, I'm happy to remind you again and again of my love which surrounds you and fills you, and then of the chance that my love won't work out quite the way as I might have drawn it out and planned it this way. But to you who are listening and wondering how, keep your feet to the fire and practice loving now. tell my story, however, whenever you're able, that my love became flesh, born in a stable. Tell others how I choose to use frail people to worship and love nurtured under this steeple. And whenever the world seems too scary and dark, remember that I chose you from the start to love you and care for you through even the end, a love that nothing ever could rend. So peace to you now and peace to you later.
And then I guess it's see you later, alligator.
I, the Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry, all who dwell in darkened sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will make their darkness bright. I will bear
one. kindness evermore. How you favor the weak and lowly one, humbling the proud of heart. You have cast the mighty down from their thrones and uplifted the humble of heart. You have filled the hungry with wondrous things and left the wealthy no part. Great and mighty are you, O faithful one. Strong is your justice, strong your love. As you promised to Sarah and Abraham, kindness forevermore. My soul proclaims your greatness, O God, and my spirit rejoices in you. You have looked with love on your servant here and blessed me all my life through.
Bless our God.
Praise and thanks to you.
May God, Creator, bless us and keep us. May Christ be ever light for our lives. May the Spirit of love be our guide and path for all of our days.
The Lord.